make another family favorite meal, and it's crowder peas, southern crowder peas. You ain't gonna find them too far north. It's a southern thing. It tastes kind of like black-eyed peas combined with their earthy tasting pea, like black-eyed peas, but they're different. And they got a good flavor and they're good for you. First thing I gotta do is go fry some bacon in the oven. So I'm gonna do that. Why am I doing it in the oven? Somebody asked. It don't make a mess on the damn stove, boy. That's why. Now you can go to Camellia's site and get crowder peas. But they were out. They seasonal. But the local farmers market has them also dried. And they're equally as good. And here they is here. And that's what they look like. See? They dried, husked, peeled, shelled, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to get them started. We need that bacon first. Now, I don't know if I ever showed y'all this trick. I've already done it on these green onions. Take and pull them, and wherever they pop off at, the rest is good. Because I've already done it on some of them. You see, this bad part popped off. So this ain't no good. See how it's all dried out looking? See there, boy? So now just wrench them off and then cut the roots off. And you got to get this little piece off down here at the bottom too. So now I got to multitask, and I hate that. In this pot, we're going to put some Trinity in there. This for them crowder peas. Getting a little on Trinity there, JB. See down there, boy? Here's that bacon I done cook off in the oven. And we need that bacon fat. Grease. We're gonna put the bacon in there too in a little bit. We ain't ready for that just yet. Let drain all that bacon grease out of that. It wasn't quite enough bacon grease. It's all right, we're gonna fix it up. We're gonna put a little bit of pure vegetable oil in there. We're gonna sweat this down and get this to cooking on the stove top. So here we got a heaping cup of Holy Trinity. And the reason we call it holy is because it's got bell pepper, no, in this order, most of onion, bell pepper, celery, and then this one also has some parsley in it. And I sweat it down with some bacon fat. You already seen that. We're going to put even more holy. We'll make it a 5-a-tea. We're going to put some water in here. Hot water. I'm supposed to be measuring this, but I just know how many quarts this pot is. Water. Got to get some garlic in there, too. And I just know how many cups. We're going to put about 2 cups of crowder peas in there. That's good 2 cups. Now, over on the stove top, got that in there. We got to get some garlic in this. We're going to bring it up to a boil and put it on low simmer. And see that red in there is red bell pepper. But any color you want.
It don't matter. It just make it pretty. You gotta get some seasonings in there too. Let's just go on and Cajunize it with some Slap Your Mama. Now, that's gonna be fine. Y'all get to know one another and come up to eat. Gotta go buck up some garlic. Let me get another beer. Garlic has two heads, two toes. Gotta go in there. It ain't all gonna cook to pieces. Don't worry about that. That Trinity gonna cook down seriously also. We're gonna probably have to add some more water.
Why didn't I add stock?
Because they got bacon in there. That's your stock. Poke stock. How about that? Oh, look at what we got here. That look like, I need to make sure the bacon's good. Oh, yeah. That was good. Got to sample every piece. Make sure it's good. Uh-huh. That was good, too. Put some in there. If I don't eat it all. Y'all go on in there, Bacons. Oink, oink, oink. Oh, it's hot too. Burning my little fingers. Ow. Yum, yum. Low bat. Get you some more batteries up in your butt, camera. All the bacon in there, boy. At least what I didn't eat. It's gonna be a fine mess of beans right here. A crowd of peas, trust me. Let's cover this and let it simmer for a good hour, maybe two. Now I gotta go on and whack these green onions up for the meatballs. For them meatballs. Evap milk. Shake the shit out of it. Cause it's settled. Rotate the can. Rotating. Church key. Open the damn can. Come on, church key, work. I know you wore out. You tired. There's some hot dog buns in there. Stale ones. Ain't no mold on them. Cause they's in the fridge. Now you can make these about 152,000 different ways. It depends on what you like. And that's what cooking's all about. Make sure your bread's good and wet. Okay? See like that down? Yeah, the bread wet. That's good. We want to see that. Get you some garlic powder. Pour it in there. Get you some seasoning salt. Slap your mama. I don't care what you slap. Put that in there. Get you some green onions. Put that in there. And this is one of my mama's meals that she used to make for us when we was a kid. And very good. Meatballs and brown gravy, right? And this is my addition. Parmigiano, Reggiano, who cares? Some damn cheese. Put all that in there. I don't think mama using green onions, but that's all right. It just feels kind of dry. Now, you don't need no eggs. We're going to leave it a little dry because we're going to deep fry, or not deep fry, we're going to fry these, pan fry them. Good boy. Good boy. You can taste it for salt right now. There ain't no eggs in it. Tastes pretty close. Need some pepper. Oh, look like I gotta go grind some more. Come out of there, boy. Didn't need much else. Just need a little splash. That'd be good. That's a splash. And I got some ground round. How now, ground cow? Moo. Moo. It was on sale. That's why I'm using the ground round. I'm going to put that in there. Make some meatballs. And I'm going to do a special. I got some toes of garlic here. And I'm going to stuff toes of garlic in the big meatballs. And I'm going to make some smaller meatballs for Miss JB because she hate biting into one of them hunks of garlic down in there. But they sure is good. So, let me carry on. Dump the damn meat in there and mix it all about. I'm gonna do that now. Meat in there, gonna get mixed. Now we're gonna mix these meatballs up. See, like that. And then we're gonna put them on that pan that I cooked that bacon in and roll them in that grease. Pay attention, boy. Now you got to worry this. I mean, worry the hell out of it. You gotta mix all this stuff up in there. And it's the only time, this and meatloaf is the only time you won't worry grind meat like this. Worry the shit out of it. I mean, look, get your thumbs all up in there. Push that seasoning inside of it. See, like that? Rip it, bust it. Y'all get happy. Make some meatballs with your little ass in just a minute. We'll make sure you distribute all of that everywheres. Now, whoop on it like that. Don't matter. Form you some meatballs. See there? Looks about golf ball size. And put them over there in that bacon grease. And worry them in that too. Make you some up. Like that. Now we got some regular sized ones. And we got some super sized ones. The super sized ones get a toe of garlic inserted. Like that. Close the hole. See there? That way we can tell them apart. And then JB be pissed if she eat one of them. That's tough. She don't like garlic. I love it. I can eat that toe raw right now. And I'll be fine with it. Uh-oh. Which one did I? Which one didn't I? I don't think this one got one. I don't want to have to go back and watch the video and figure it out. Then we got a little sampler ball right here. Roll all around in that bacon grease, boy. Yum. All of y'all. Now we're gonna deep fry it. We're gonna fry this on, bitch. Stop, boy, stop. Now I got me a cast iron skillet right here. We're going to put some Earl in there. Let's check on them crowder peas. Oh, they smell good. Ain't nothing like no crowder peas cooking. Nothing smells like them. They special. This is like better than red beans and rice. Better than pinto beans.
You know we're gonna serve this over some rice. Trust me, boy. Alright, so now, oh, turn the fire on, JB. Be non-union. We are ready. Put our sample in that face. Because you know we gotta taste it. And then we'll put us a garlic ball. Another garlic ball. You don't want to crowd the pan too badly. Alright, it's time to rotate them. Like that. You want that good brown color on them. Turn over there, boy. Come on, little sample. How you coming now? Yum. All right, tripod, you ain't cooperating. Now you will. It's time to get this batch out and start the non-union batch over here. You see there? Put them right there. We'll have one more batch to go. Where my sample? Oh, I see him over there. That's good. Y'all cook. I knew it. Yum! Oh. Yum, yum, yum. The second batch. Ready to come out. Drain them? Uh-huh. Put them in there with the bacon. Where the bacon cooked. They'll drain right there. Now let's get the third batch in there. Oh, Lord. Be careful, JB, that grease is hot. I kind of slung it in there. Don't worry about putting them back on that pan with the raw meat. Because they're going to get cooked some more. I'm gonna go ahead and make sure I identify the ones with the garlic in it. One more toothpick allowed, no dogs allowed. Now, all right, third batch coming out. Now we're gonna have to drain this grease out. We just need to. Mama would just cook them. Cook the rest of the stuff right there in that grease. But I know better. Turn the fire off and let this cool down some. I just read a personal message on the spring fling thing. They got some people coming in from the east and west coast. Y'all may want to mention to one another. If you want a carpool, it'd be cheaper. You know, if you're not bringing down a whole family or something like that. So, figure it out for your damn self, boy. And I'm gonna keep them meatballs warm in the oven. Somebody else wrote in and said, will it stop my drain pipes up if I pour this grease down the zinc pipe? Yeah, it will. If your house is not plumbed right, In other words, if the pipes aren't going downhill all the time, they'll eventually build up with grease. So you really want to run some hot water, or just burrow you a pot of water on a stove. And if you're going to put the grease down there, put the grease in the sink and dump that whole pot of hot water behind it and chase it. It's going to push that grease out. Now, if you got one of them anaerobic septic systems, don't do it. Never mind, just stay screwed. Now, you got to water these beans every now and then. See how they coming? The peas, a crowd of peas. Man, I remember down there in Oak Grove, Louisiana, they had this old black man that had a farm, and he'd grow them and sell them to you in the shell. You had to go shuck them yourself. Oh, they were good fresh out the shell like that. These are dried that I use, and they still real damn fine. They were fresh shucked out the shell. Oh, man, them is good. Don't get much finer than living in Louisiana. Okie dokie, boy, I really hate to do this, because there's some flavor in there. But I got to. Can't have this much grease in this. There go the majority of the grease. Now we can continue with this. And being as I'm a union plumber, I ran a dedicated 3-inch pipe all the way around to the city sewer main. I don't have no septic system yet. Now they would drain some of the grease out. Let's dump some onions in there. You see your onions done brown, dump you in some rough whack bell peppers and worry them around a little bit. See how pretty that looks? Dump some water in there. And once your vegetables are good and sweated down like that, and I done put water in there, I guess y'all saw that shot. Get you a heaping tablespoon of flour, some Cajun seasoning, and we're gonna put some water in there and mix that up. Now use cold water. Don't put no hot water in here. You're gonna have lumpy biscuits. Same way with cornstarch or anything like that. Make sure you got it all mixed up really good. Now you can go pour this in your gravy and it's going to thicken it up a lot. And you got to cook that flour down a little bit. You don't want this to taste like biscuits. To make Cajun rice, it's a 2-to-1 ratio. 2 parts water, 1 part rice. Put some salt in there. Salt to water. Some salt. And that was 4 cups of water, a teaspoon of salt. That's all you need. Now once your gravy is getting real close, we gotta get them meatballs in there. It's all in meatballs. Y'all go up in there and get to know Mr. Gravy. I see warning meatballs and spit out a piece of garlic. Oh, that's mine. It's a sampler. Damn right it is. Oh. Yum, boy. Man, ain't that gonna be fine. The toothpick ones, I already told you. If you don't know, just stay stupid. Now let's tell everybody in the family this is ready.
This is ready.
favorite rice spoon? Get you some rice like that in there. Put them down there on top of that rice. Damn, that's a slotted spoon. I don't know if I like that. I want some of that gravy from them peas down there on there. Oh yeah. I can see I'm gonna have to get two plates to hold all this. See them in there floating with them toothpicks? That's the ones I want. Put them right down there. See that piece of garlic trying to get out of there? Yeah, boy, stay in there. Oh, yum. Another gravy scooper. See right there? See down there? Gravy. You see right there? There's your food. Eat that.